will be your teacher tonight. So you will cook for yourself, your friend cook for themselves. You can make your food spicy, medium, vegetarian, no problem. But the problem is when you burn your food, you have to close your eyes and eat it. And no cry. Anyone vegetarian today?
Maybe.
Okay.
Maybe
six. Okay. So right now we are at the Market. We inside of the old city. Chiang Mai, 721 years old. And this is the oldest wooden market in Chiang Mai. Wherever you go now, you don't see the wooden like this anymore. Everything concrete now. Yeah. So this is the real local one. Because of the Happy New Year, a few shops they close, the coconut meal and the rice shop close. So now we're gonna see vegetable and some of fruit and egg. So the first one, I'm explaining something that you don't expect to learn. That whenever you buy egg, you shake the egg like this. If you hear nothing in the egg, good one. If you hear the water in the egg, okay, not a good one. Another way, you put in water when it sink, good one. When it flood, not a good one. And to buy, if possible, choose the small one. Small egg come from young hen. So the young hen still healthy and strong, so good flavor. When the hen lay egg longer, the egg bigger, but the hen's older. So big egg come from the own hen. Yeah, this one come from duck, this one from chicken. And this one we fermented the egg for about 45 days. Yeah, we got this one 1,000 years old egg or century egg. Just for rice soup or salad, but the smell similar to a horse pee. So
Thai
people give the name to this egg, horse pee egg.
Horse pee egg.
Okay. So this is the horse pee egg, 1,000 years old egg. I say, okay, if you want to know, then you buy me egg and buy me chicken. You ready? But you have egg and chicken in your hands, throw both of them up to the sky. Once both of them drop back, then you got the answer. Because the egg broken, chicken still alive, chicken come first. Look at the chili first. Yeah, we have three different kinds. This is the Tabasco, less spicy. This is the jalapeno chili, medium spicy. Super spicy, the smallest one. Then we call them bird eye chilies. So the red one is the old one, less spicy. The green one stronger because the young one. And to use the chili to get away from the insect, you cannot use the fresh one. You must use only the dry chili. Yeah, it could be the small one or the big one, but the small one better because it has stronger spiciness, stronger smell. Yeah. And when you buy the fresh one, first thing you need to look on the top, look at the stem. If you see they are green, this is new one. If you see they are black, already a few days at the market. The eggplant or whatever, you look from the top like this. And the next one after the chili, we're gonna see this one, same but different. The big one, the yellow one is lemon. The middle one is bergamot or kaffir lime. This is the normal lime. The kaffir lime or the bergamot, the leaf look like this. This is the leaf. This is a fruit. So the leaf is an essential ingredient we are to use in our soup and curry. Smell this? Very nice smell. And the skin, when you get headache from hangover, then you use this one to make tea. You peel the skin, add in hot water. Hello? And how to buy them? They're good or not, you have to squeeze them. If they are very hard, not the good one, because they are too young, less juice. If they are soft, good one. And when you buy the onion, if they are hard, good one. Soft, not the good one. Never buy before, call your friend come closer and then hit his head. If his head swollen, okay, bye. So this one you buy the hard one, this one you buy the soft one. Yeah? And garlic, shallot, you do the same like the onion. You buy the hard one only.
the easy one, the potato, carrot, tomato, tomato, you know, cauliflower, broccoli, you know. Now this one, the confusing one about the eggplants. Whenever I say eggplants, many people thinking about the purple one. So the big, the purple one, we call aubergine. This one we call eggplants because it looks like an egg and it comes from a plant. Then the name called eggplants. This one we call the long aubergine. And this one is the quail egg eggplant, just about the quail egg size. And moreover, we have the tiny one. I think you have seen them in red or green curry. Yeah, this one, it's just about the pea size, but the plant look the same like the big one. Then we give the name pea eggplants. Yeah, this one, they taste horrible, very bitter, but it's a painkiller. Yeah, when you get muscle egg, you eat this, it releases the pain. Yeah, because long time ago, 90 years, 100 years, Thailand poor country, not many hospitals. So everyone eat medicine from food. Like this. In here. Thank you. Okay, something that nearby, you want to know something, you pick up, I cannot reach over there. That one first, okay, on the plastic bag there next to you. Yes, yes. Yeah, that one, that one. Yeah, thank you very much. Everyone, this one is the morning curry. So why we call this vegetable morning curry? Why don't we call evening curry? Somebody know why or not? Yeah, because every morning when the sun rises, then the flower moves. When the sun sets, then the flower sleeps. There are three varieties. It could be a purple stem, or white or green. Yeah, flower two color, purple or white. This one high vitamin A, good for eyes. For minimum 4 hours. Better overnight. So every time before sleeping, rice in the water. Next morning, cooking. Okay, the steam is rice. The steam holes bigger than the rice grains. So I use the cotton bag to block the hole first. Only the cotton one, I don't use the other one. Put the rice into the basket. You don't turn around when you do at home. I do like this because I want you to see. Wash before soak one time and after soaking one time. So wash twice, before and after. If you soak too long, yeah, more than 2 days, then you will use that one for make moonshine. Because the rice is sour. Together. Once we make it. And if you want to know, stick your rice, you can allow. Allow that. Stick your rice, yeah, be high coconut tree or stick your rice. Four hour minimum. But about 4 hours. Okay, from now, half an hour until 5 o'clock today. Five past five. Yeah, 25 minutes. Okay, now what to do next? When you do the curry, you will use a pot or the wok. If you have the wok, you use the wok, wooden spoon, and this. And for the soup, using this. And for me, when I demonstrate, I will let you borrow your wok. To cut Thai chicken decaptionate, just the spatula. And the wok will give you later. Three different of the level of heat, high, medium, and low. Yeah. Press like this and turn left. 9 o'clock, high heat. Low heat, turn the whole way left to 6 o'clock. Medium heat, between 6 and 9. What I do now, I'm going to prepare pak and sour soup for you to enjoy. Yeah.
Name in English, we call hot and sour soup. Name in Thai, we say tom yum. If you say tom in Thai language, in English it means soup. When you say yum, it means yummy. So tom yum actually it means yummy soup. If you add chicken, then we say kai. Tom yum kai. So you can add chicken, beef, pork, whatever. Yeah, the ingredients are lemongrass. So this one we don't eat, so we cut in big pieces. Should do this side first, like this. Like that, this pieces like this. And then add it. And the next one is the root that we have seen, look like the ginger. That we call kalanga. They're cut in half. And the next one is the bergamot or cafe lamli. Stem at the middle, bitter. So remove the stem. So whenever you see three of them, you don't eat them. Yeah, we add in just for flavor.
Oh, okay.
Many people don't know they eat. Okay, nothing wrong to you. Two ingredients that you don't prepare, plum and coriander for the end. Tomato, cut across three pieces. The garlic, the root and the blunt end. The sharp and not a root, so you cut out a root first. And then drop to the bin. Pour a knife like this, exactly the middle. And then hold the end. And then cut in half. Done. Shallot already washed and clean. Yeah, crush it like this. To have more flavor. If not, then you use the onion, the mushroom, the any kind of mushroom you can use. This one we call the white Chinese mushroom, similar to the oyster one. Just make it easy to bite. This is a family of oyster mushroom we call white Chinese mushroom. You can use like a champignon, shiitake or whatever. But the only one mushroom you don't use is the magic mushroom. The chili, the red one. You don't go home, I want to sleep here. Okay, cut off the stem. I use two. After you test my one, so you can use 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to you. Okay. Now cut in half. Don't touch. Lift up the chopping block. Two ingredients for the end. And this one don't have anything with them. This is the tom yum paste. Garlic, shallot, chili, fried together.
Garlic, chili, fried together. Chili paste.
This is the fish sauce. This one, prawn. Nothing in the pot yet. Okay, now for one serving, we will use 1 cup water.
Oh, I didn't know you're passing the command.
When you do this, you don't use a wok, use a pot. I do this because everyone can see. Okay, everyone, now to make it easy to remember, every soup, what you have to remember, you have to add herbs before you add meat. Lemongrass, garlic, shallot, chili, kaffiran leaves, and then boil them. Once the water boiling, the heat starting to release the flavor from the herbs, then you add in chicken, beef, pork, chicken, kangaroo, tiger, snake, crocodile, rabbit, ostrich, emu, tiger, elephant, spider, scorpion, panda.
Say again.
Okay, but today we have small quantity, only one serving. Then we combine mushroom with tomato same time. If you do about 5 serving, mushroom, tomato, outside. And after the chicken cook, then add mushroom and tomato, like this. And then the one that we can prepare for you is like this. Your chicken, fish sauce, and tom yum paste already in the bowl for you. But I will add one by one because you can see every step. And I add tom yum paste.
Now what is that? Food. Chili paste?
Yeah, chili paste. Garlic, shallot, chili. Now the water getting hot. Now add chicken in this time because the flavor of the herbs starting to release in the water. Chicken go in and stir a little bit to separate them. Yeah, don't let them stick together because they are not on honeymoon. Yeah, separate them.
Well, we never know. So we do have honeymoon.
For the prawn, fish or squid, you have to add last minute. Add in when you see the water look like a hot spring. Mm-hmm. Okay, when you see the water rapidly boiling, if you can eat prawn, this time add prawn. Why we have to wait like this? Because the heat will bring out the smell. If the water cold, then you have the prawn smell in the soup. Right now the prawn doesn't cook yet, how do we know?
That's
the color. That's still alive, jumping down. It turned orange color. Correct. Okay, now 80% cooked. Chicken done. Yeah, very fast. Take about 3 minutes. Done. Coriander go in. Hit off. Where's the ginseng? Finished. Now fish sauce, 1 tablespoon. Exactly.
Can we add soy sauce instead of fish sauce?
No problem.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah, it smells too fishy.
You don't smell fish. Everyone, pick up your spoon. Yeah. This is the true chili. If you can test my one, yeah, your spoon on the table. Okay, pick up your spoon and try. Cigarette. Oh, something different at full moon night. Now you see the flower.
Oh, ah. Yeah.
Stop fire first. Stop fire.